Hello friends, welcome to All Basic. Friends, today we will know about sessions of parliament. Sessions of parliament. Summoning. The president from time to time summons each house of parliament to meet, but the maximum gap between the two houses of parliament cannot be more than 6 months. In other words, the parliament should meet at least twice a year. The budget session, February to May, the monsoon session, July to September, and the winter session, November to December. A session of parliament is the period spanning between the first sitting of parliament and its prorogation or dissolution in the case of Lok Sabha. During a session, the house meets every day to transact business. The period spanning between the prorogation of a house and its reassembly in a new session is called recess. Adjournment. An adjournment suspends the work in a sitting for a specified time, which may be hours, days, or weeks. Adjournment sine die. Adjournment sine die means terminating a sitting of parliament for an indefinite period. In other words, when the house is adjourned without naming a day for reassembly, it is called adjournment sine die. The power of adjournment as well as adjournment sine die lies with the presiding officer of the house. Prorogation. It not only terminates a sitting but also a session of the house. It is done by the President of India. Dissolution. Rajya Sabha, being a permanent house, is not subject to dissolution. Only the Lok Sabha is subject to dissolution. Unlike a prorogation, a dissolution ends the very life of the existing house and a new house is constituted after general election are held. When the Lok Sabha is dissolved, all business including bills, motions, resolutions, notices, petitions and so on pending before it or its committees lapse. They to be pursued further must be reintroduced in the newly constituted Lok Sabha. However, some pending bills and all pending assurance that are to be examined by the committees on government assurance do not lapse on the dissolution of the Lok Sabha. Quorum. Quorum is the minimum number of members required to be present in the house before it can transact any business. It is 1/10 of the total number of members in each house, including the presiding officer. It means that there must be at least 55 members present in the Lok Sabha and 25 members present in the Rajya Sabha if any business is to be conducted. Language in Parliament. The Constitution has declared Hindi and English to be the languages for transacting business in the Parliament. However, the presiding officer can permit a member to address the house in his mother tongue in both the houses. Arrangements are made for simultaneous translation. Though English was to be discontinued as a floor language after the expiration of 15 years from the commencement of the Constitution, that is in 1965, the Official Language Act 1963 allowed English to be continued along with Hindi. Rights of Ministers and Attorney General. In addition to the members of a house, every minister and the Attorney General of India have the right to speak and take part in the proceeding of either house, any joint sitting of both the houses and any committee of parliament of which he is a member without being entitled to vote. Lame duck session. It refers to the last session of the existing Lok Sabha after a new Lok Sabha has been elected. Those members of the existing Lok Sabha who could not get re-elected to the newly Lok Sabha are called lame ducks. Today's question. Adjournment versus prorogation. Adjournment. It only terminates a sitting and not a session of the house. Prorogation. It not only terminates a sitting but also a session of the house. Adjournment. It is done by the presiding officer of the house. Prorogation. It is done by the President of India. Adjournment. It does not affect the bills or any other business pending before the House, and the same can be resumed when the House meets again. Prorogation. It also does not affect the bills or any other business pending before the House. However, all pending notices other than those for including introducing bills lapse on prorogation, and fresh notices have to be given for the next session. In Britain, prorogation brings to an end all bills or any other business pending before the House. Today's word, sine die, with no appointed date for resumption. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe.